the topic we're entering is now industries. I'll focus on the Indian industries. Paper 2 ke point of view se padh rahe hain. Paper 1 mein we do not need, because the questions aaye nahi hain, so I'm ignoring that for now. Industries paper 2. Now there are 4-5 type of questions that they ask you. They ask you about what is the location pattern and the factors associated. Okay, they ask you this. Then they can ask you about what are the issues related to industrial development, and related to this you can discuss something around the policies. And of course in recent times they've asked, okay, some things related to what are the problems, what are the problems and challenges. Fourth area that they ask you is India's industrial regions. What are industrial regions of India? Now the location pattern and factors, this is the more commonly asked question. Okay, this area is the more commonly asked question. And if you look at the bulk of the questions, they have asked on cotton, they have asked on iron and steel industries. We have had questions, okay, one or two questions we have had on automobile, and we have had on agro-based. But the dominant questions have been on steel and cotton. Baki, this is more of miscellaneous type of topics. The syllabus gives you a very long list, but I suggest it does not make sense that you read all the industries at the same time. Be selective here. This is a topic you have to be very, very selective. Industrial development policies, they have asked about Make in India. They've asked problems related to challenges. They have asked problems related to or issues related to MNCs in India. The industrial disparities, we can have questions. All, there are not too many questions asked here. And whatever questions we have are primarily here. Location pattern. Or thoda baat industrial development problems bhi aap log dekh lena. I will help you on this. Recently, they asked one on industrial regions also. But I'll suggest, even if they do not ask, industry is very important to discuss. Okay, so industries are integral to understanding regional development. They are integral to understanding problems of regional disparities. Industries, they are part of India's trade also, if you know what productions we have. So direct questions may be less, but indirectly there is a good amount of overlap with many topics beyond industries also. So as economic geography may, the industries will be important. Okay, be selective, but then make sure that you know the basics of the sector. Aap isko pura chhod mat dena. Okay, is one suggestion to you. Now, that's one. Now, another aspect of industries is, okay, that you have to use geography concepts. Industries can be studied. Say, if I'm discussing industries, there are two ways of discussing industries. One is to discuss the sector. You're discussing the economics. You're talking about industrial performance, you are discussing investments, okay, and so on. This is typical, the economy perspective. Like you talk about labor reforms. The second is the geography perspective. Geography perspective is about location. Geography perspective is about regional, okay, development component. You have to bring some laws into studies. Like say, think of Weber's. Okay, Weber's law about the role of transport, the role of labor, the least cost theory. So, aapko na geography lena hoga. And while discussing the locations, while you're discussing locations, you need to bring in, okay, specific centers. What is the pattern? What are the factors? How and why do we have dispersal? why and how we have dispersal of industries. So most of the students, they are trapped because they cannot deal with this. Okay, and this is the hardcore geography part. The sector, say, economy, mein, the approach will be studying IIP, studying the performance of the core sectors. Okay, you can talk about investments, what are the budget proposals. So all of this, of course, does have some relationship with this also. But when you study industries, make sure that these three aspects of geography are obvious. The location aspect, kahan par hai, kyun hai, what's the pattern, how industries disperse and spread, how industries occupy the bulk of or not occupy good parts of India. The regional pattern, the pattern of industries in northern plains is not same as the pattern of industries in the regions of southern India, is not same as industries in northeast India, not same as industries along the coast. Kuch ek regional pattern hoga. And link them with the laws. Okay, laws of Weber, you can bring in the laws related to innovation diffusion. We can use laws related to disparity. Think of a cumulative causation model. And I think you remember what I call, what we have studied or mentioned at least as the core periphery model. So aapko kuch na kuch laws ke saath baat karna. What are the laws? What are the theories? Okay. What are some of those technical say developments as a part of understanding and generalizing the patterns of industrial location and distribution? So this is where our focus will be, okay, the geography. And unfortunately, your textbooks, they have this, but the discussion is not as comprehensive. Maybe there's some passing reference they can chhod dete hai. Okay. So the class notes will be important in studying this. Okay, I think you have a fair idea about this topic now. I've discussed what all they can ask you. They can ask you location patterns. They can ask you industrial development problems, and they can ask you industrial regions. Ye teen broad category of questions hai. But otherwise also, I'm saying industries are integral to understanding problems of regional development and regional disparities. They are integral to understanding trade. Integral to understanding agriculture development industries. So, har jagah kahin na kahin something or the other we will have here. Okay, but in geography writings, you have to bring in the geographical perspective. Okay, the geographical perspective is something, yes. Okay, EEZ, SEZ, these are all part of the location patterns. The location patterns will include, okay, the SEZs. The location patterns will include industrial clusters. So sector, the economic and the industrial performance, investments in industries, the labor issues, labor reforms in industries, okay, index of industrial production, IIP, discussion on core sectors, budgetary provisions. These are the economy aspects of industries. We need this, but not in as much detail. The geography elements are a bit different. Okay, geography elements are a bit different. Now, the first discussion is, what is the importance of industries? What is the significance of appreciating industries? So basically, industries are an important element of development. A lot of development does not happen if the areas do not have industries. If you look at the development of Europe, if you look at the development of India, if you look at why Maharashtra is what it is, or why Gujarat is what it is, and Andhra Pradesh what it is, and why UP has not done as well, and why has Northeast not done as well, what are the gaps in Bihar, in Odisha, okay? You find that industries have been a very important decisive factor. Okay, industries are a very important element of development. Aur ye jo perspective, this idea has been emphasized in Rostov's model. It is a very much industrialization-led model. Like if you look at the stage 2, stage 3, stage 4, okay, if you look at the discussions related to elements of preconditions of takeoff, if you look at the stage of drive towards maturity, these stages, they are related to. These stages are related to industrial development. I mean, just demonstrating how I bring geography into otherwise an economy topic. How to bring geography into economy topic is use some of the theories, models related to geography. So Rostov's model is one way I'm doing that. Rostov's model talks about that development, the most important element hai industries, and at least three stages directly depend on industrial development. Preconditions where the basic infrastructure is developing, takeoff, this is the public sector involvement in industries, and a drive towards maturity, where you have got more private sector, more of robust systems, industries. Rostov's model emphasizes industries are important. Vaise, if you look at the theory of Gunnar Myrdal, the cumulative causation of growth and development is related to industrial development and the associated urbanization. So another reference to some theory, Gunnar Myrdal, he gave us a theory called as cumulative causation theory. Cumulative causation theory, it says that some areas can develop advantage and those areas can keep on growing and expanding while the other areas are not developed as much. So cumulative causation is related to industrial development. Some areas have industries, some areas have the beginnings of the modern industries, and those areas, they develop synergies of growth and the rest, and they start expanding. Okay. So cumulative causation, like it talks about industries and urbanization as the basis of why some areas grow and others do not grow. If you look at the growth pole model, Peru's model of growth pole, where the growth poles are industrial centers, are industrial firms. The growth poles are industrial sectors. And to this, if you remember, we added Bourdieu's theory. He talked about industrial locations as growth centers. Okay, so industries, the importance, emphasizing, I said, look at what Rostov's model says, look at what cumulative causation model says, look at what growth pole model says. All of them talk about, agar development hai, development happens because of industries. And if development is not there, it's because the region does not have industries. So if I take this conversation forward, we have another model I'll talk about afterwards, something called as the core periphery model of development. And this model also says that trickle down and growth spread, okay, happens with industrialization. So I'm just trying to give some technical basis to our discussions on what is the significance of industries. I know when you talk about significance, you could talk in terms of industries help us agriculture development, industries will help us, okay, connectivity, industries will help us labor employment, industries will help us raw material use. We know all those points. So what I have done is I've related industries to certain theories. Okay, the core periphery model as a theory, the growth pole model as a theory, the cumulative causation model as a theory, and the Rostov's model as a theory. So I'm trying to give it some kind of technical base as to why industries are important. And of course, to this you could always add, what is the significance in more, okay, common words, and significance is that they help develop labor employment, they help us use raw material development hota isse. Industries are related to infrastructure, industries are related to technology innovations, and all of this can lead to, okay, better economy. All of this can lead to better investments, better trade, and overall better quality of life. So I think this part of conversation, this part of conversation, all of us are okay with. You understand this. It is the one on the right where I have brought in a bit of geography. Okay, or technical detailing of why industries are important. Did you all understand how we are relating these technical aspects into answers now? This is the general discussion about why are industries important. On the right-hand side, I have related the importance of industries in relationship to certain theories. The growth pole theory, you know. Rostov's model, you know. Even Gunnar Mittal's cumulative causation theory. I have mentioned this while discussing your primate city concept. While discussing primate city, I have mentioned this. Okay, look up your notes once again. Okay, and core periphery, I have not discussed. I will do this afterwards. Abhi aap likh lo bas. So what I have written here is, in the core periphery model of development, the trickle down and the growth and spread happens with industries. Growth and spread of development. Drive towards maturity. So all of these are stages. The preconditions of takeoff is a stage. Takeoff is a stage. Drive towards mature stage. All these stages are related to industrial development. Okay. Growth poles, industries or industrial firms, industrial sectors, these are the growth poles. Okay. Bourdieu says industrial locations can be growth centers. This is Bourdieu's theory. And one more important linkage you can add here, I could have mentioned earlier itself, that industries are related to urbanization, have a backward and a forward linkage with agriculture development. Okay. Industries have a forward linkage. They can become agriculture processing, and they also have a backward linkage. Industries can provide fertilizers. Industries can provide tractors. Industries have a forward and a backward linkage with agriculture development. Industries are also related to urbanization. So this also is a relationship of why industries are important. Okay, fine. We are moving on now. Okay, you have seen this through this now. The next one is, what are the factors of industrial location? What are the factors of industrial patterns? What are the reasons why industries get located where they are? What are the reasons why the patterns develop? Like in India, if you see, the typical pattern is that we have 5 to 6 main industrial clusters. We have industries in Chudanagpur Plateau and West Bengal, Dhanbad, Bokaro, Chittaranjan, Asansol, Kolkata, that's one. We have industries in Ahmedabad, Mehsana, Kandla, Ankleshwar, okay. Some refining industries wahan par hai. We have a cluster around Mumbai, Thane, Trombay, Raigarh, towards Pune. That's an important cluster here. We have industrial cluster around Coimbatore, Tirupur, Erode, okay, Salem region, ye industrial cluster hai. We have one cluster around Delhi. Okay. So there are 5-6 clusters across the major ones, the major industrial regions. So my question is, what are the factors? What are the factors why industrial locations come up? What are the factors that influence industrial patterns? But yes, raw material is one, market is one, exactly. Okay, transport is a very important factor. Old history, yes. History, water availability, trade, transport, connectivity, cheap labor. Yes, I think you have that. Even political reasons, absolutely. Okay, political decision making. Yes, government policies are important. If government policies will overwhelm perhaps most of the other factors. Strategic factors, yes. Okay, we would like to keep some industries at some location because of some strategic security concerns. Okay, yes, electricity, power, ports. Okay, fine. Now, you know the reasons. Now, what I'm doing is I'm organizing this. So, you know the reasons why industries are where they are. I'm trying to put that into a some kind of organized format. So, you remember this now. So, this could be your industrial location pentagon. Raw material is very, very important. Very important factor is labor, transport is important, and we have even capital is very important. The capital as an investment, capital and finances, and we have technology. These are the main, when I say raw material, I could mean mines are important. I could mean water is important. Raw material may hi aa jayega, maybe even power resources are important. And for all of this, we need labor, we need transport. So if you divide the factors, you'll find that your raw material, labor and transport, the raw material, labor and transport, and even to some extent capital, capital as in investments, these are related to site. They are related to locations. Like say, why do industries come up in Mumbai? Okay, or around Mumbai is because the location of Mumbai with its port, location of Mumbai in terms of the urban center, the location is aisa hai that you are bound to have more investments than the other centers. And transport, labor, capital, technology, this is also influenced by policies. These are conscious government interventions. So we have a pentagon here. See, dekho, whatever you have said is what I have written here. But you realize that the way you organize the answers are important. Okay, so it should not be like a layman listing down the points. Okay, so I've given is some kind of a structure to our discussion. So raw material, which is mines and minerals, water, power, labor issues, transport, and even capital finance. These are related to the site and the location. Okay, kahan par hai? Okay, what location? And then I said, raw material, of course, even in raw material exploitation, there is some role of government. But the government plays a more active role indirectly there. Directly, they can influence labor. Directly, they can influence transport and infrastructure. Isme aapka hum yahan pe ports bhi add kar denge. I can add large container yards. We can talk about warehousing here. Technology, absolutely, yes. Okay, so all of them are related. That's why ultimately we are going to have these kind of linkage. Agar aap dekhoge, this ultimately is this type of a linkage. It's a complicated linkage like this, where everything impacts everything else. This is not an isolated system. Yes, power can also be added. Technology to beta everywhere. Technology is linked to raw material, linked to labor, linked to transport, linked to capital finance also. Okay, so if you look at the diagram, this perhaps captures what are the factors that influence your location. And these can be discussed in one more way. There are certain direct geographical and location factors, and there are certain indirect factors. Direct geographical factors are related to the site. Direct geographical factors are related to climate. Direct geographical factors is related to connectivity. Direct geographical factor is labor, location. Indirect factors, we're talking about capital investments. Indirect one, research and development. Indirect one, the policies that we have. So more or less, this captures the discussion on what are the factors that influence location of industries. Policies, government interventions, there are certain consumer issues related. So these are essentially consumer issues related, policies issues, government interactions, consumer issues, governance issues. These are governance. So there are direct geographical factors and there are indirect factors. Site and location, climate. Can you give an example where climate decides industrial location? Food processing, absolutely, yes. Vineyards, tea and coffee gardens. And if you're talking about, basically all agro-based industries are related to climate. Agro-based industries, they will be related to climate. Okay, yes, you can go on there. And in today's development, solar energy, it is climate-based. Okay, so climate also, and climate, a core example, a nice example. Why did Bangalore become a center of software technology? Give me one big reason. Why did Bangalore become the centers for software industries and software development? Why? Good climate, absolutely. It kind of mimics the climate of the US Western Coast. Yes, climate. So climate also plays a very important role. Jaise ki ek aur important example hai climate ka, cotton weaving, cotton industries, they require a humid climate. If the climate is dry, the threads will break. They require warm and humid climates. Or jahan par warm humid nahi hai, they use artificial humidifiers. Okay, so climate is a very important factor in industrial location. So you can give example of Bangalore here. You can talk about examples of cotton industries that require humid climate. So remember, ye jo discussion hai, use the discussion in any question of industry. This can almost become a kind of a formula suggestion for any discussions on industries. Okay, what are the factors and which of them are site-based, which are based on government policy and governance, and from this the direct geographical factors and indirect factors. Okay, now take out your Khulla textbook, please. Okay, this is your Khulla textbook, the new edition that we have been discussing. Take it out. And please look at page number 882, 883. So 882 mein, the geographical factors are raw material, power, labor, transport. In fact, you can also add market location. In fact, yehi to hai, the raw material, the labor, and the market. Interaction of this is what gives us the Weber's model. So market location is also a geographical factor. Directly we study in geography. That's the whole idea. And what I mean by geographical factor is all those directly is a part of your geographical discussions. Okay? So raw material, power, labor, transport, market, and water. So raw material includes site will decide raw material. So what ho gaya? And look at the non-geographical factors. There's capital, investments, government policies. Look at page 884 and 885. Capital, government policies, industry inertia, organization, banking facilities, insurance, the whole range of finances and the rest. Capital, finances, and insurance. So keeping this one in mind, we will discuss the specific industries.